Welcome to the Department of Collegiate and Technical Education. This is the session 49 on course Water Supply Engineering of third semester Civil Engineering. This session is on Unit 6. The name of the unit is Water Pollution and Control. The content which we are going to discuss in this session is types of water pollution. The water pollution broadly divided into the following four categories. First one is physical pollution, second one is chemical pollution, third one is bacteriological pollution, and fourth one is radioactive pollution. We will discuss on first one, that is physical pollution. The physical pollution of water is due to the following factors. The factors are, first one is color, second one is taste and odor, third one is temperature, fourth one is turbidity, fifth one is suspended matter, and sixth one is foam. These are the factors because of this physical pollution of water will take place. We will discuss first one, physical pollutant, that is color. The water bodies may be receiving color from natural or artificial sources. The sources which cause the color in the water is because of natural or artificial source. The discharge from many industries may be colored, and such a discharge into natural water bodies imparts color to the water of such a water body. For example, the industries such as discharging lignin, textile industries, tanneries, discharging tannins, these are the industries which give color to the water of the natural sources. It may be noted that pollution of water due to color is mainly an aesthetic one, and in many cases it does not develop any threat to the public health. That means the color of the water will not cause any threat to the public health, but for the aesthetic purpose it is objectionable. Next one is a taste and odor. The industry's waste contain many strong smelling chemicals compounds, and when such a trade wastes are discharged into rivers or streams, the water of such a rivers or streams get unpleasant smell and taste and odor. Thus, the industries which discharge strong smelling chemicals into the natural source of water, because of that, the natural source of water such as rivers and streams will get unpleasant taste and odor. Some of the chemicals which produce taste and odor in the natural source of water are the salts, iron, manganese, trichlorine, hydrogen sulfide, phenols, unsaturated hydrocarbons. These are the substances, or these are the materials, because of this the water will get some taste and odor other than the natural taste. Sometimes taste and odor in water are developed due to odorous substances produced by algae. Apart from the chemicals, sometimes the algae also produce some taste and odor in the water. Taste and odor in water in general have no real public health significance, which means the taste water having some taste and odor will not cause any issue with regards public health, but it has some effects as said below. First one is, such a waters may prove detrimental to fish life and may damage the value of fisheries, which means the some taste and odor water will be dangerous to the fish life, and sometime it will also reduce the value of fisheries. Next one is, such a waters are not liked by public and they are rejected even in preference to tasteless and odorless waters of poor quality. So poor quality water is rejected by the public. If taste and odor in water are due to certain toxic chemicals, chemical gases, the use of such a water may seriously injure the public health. Normally, the taste and odor will not affect the public health, but sometimes some toxic chemicals create a taste and odor in the water, then such a water is dangerous to the or injurious to the public health. Next one is a temperature. If the temperature of trade wastes which are discharged into rivers or streams is high, there is rise of temperature of such a water bodies, which means if we discharge a waste which has a high temperature, then that discharge will create a temperature rise in the natural source of water. For instance, the cooling of water from thermal and nuclear stations. For example, the water which is used for cooling purpose in the thermal and nuclear power station, which has a considerable warm water, if such a water is directly discharged into the natural water bodies, it will result in the rise of temperature of water of such a natural bodies. The thermal pollution of water is objected because it develops the following two contradictory conditions. The conditions which is created by the temperature is, the first one is the activity of biological life is more at higher temperature, and hence as temperature of water rises, there is a more demand for dissolved oxygen. As the temperature of the water increases, the biological activities also increase in the water. The biological activity require oxygen, hence the oxygen of the water will get reduced. And next one is the oxygen has a peculiar property of inverse solubility. That means its solubility in water is inversely proportional to temperature. That means if the temperature of the water is more, then the dissolved oxygen content or oxygen solubility in water will get reduced. As the temperature of water rises, the available quantity of dissolved oxygen decreases in the water. When the oxygen content is reduced, the freshness of the water will be reduced. Next one is a turbidity. Next one, physical pollution is a turbidity. The water becomes turbid due to the presence of the following. What the factors are, the materials which cause the turbidity in water are colloidal matter or very finely divided suspended matter, which settles only with a great difficulty. Next one is the salts of iron and manganese, which are oxidized to their hydroxides. Next one is a sewage. Next one, industrial wastes of certain trades. These are the material which create turbidity in water. The turbidity of water is usually not objectionable from the consideration of public health, except when it occurs due to the bacterial contamination of sewage. Normally, the turbid water will not create any threat to the public health, but when it occurs from the bacteriological contamination, that means if turbidity is because of bacteriological contamination, then which may create dangerous or which may create threat, which may create a threat to the public health. Next one is a suspended matter. The insoluble suspended matter present in water pollutes water. Such matter may be organic or inorganic in nature. That means organic and inorganic suspended material present in the water create a pollution in the water. The presence of such a matter in water bodies indicates contamination either by sewage or some industrial waste. The presence of organic or inorganic material indicates that the presence of contamination, that may be by the sewage or by the industrial waste. The pollution of water due to suspended matter is not very serious, as such matter can be easily detected and removed. This suspended material can be easily removed by the water, easily removed from the water. That's why it will not create any serious matter. But presence of suspended matter in water is objected from the following consideration. But for some reasons, the presence of suspended matter is avoided. That is, the presence of light in water is, the penetration of light in water is dim, and it may seriously affect the normal life of plants. If suspended material is present in the water, the penetration of light in water is dim, and it may affect the normal life of plants which present in the water. It can damage fisheries. The suspended material also can damage the fisheries, and water gets undesirable appearance. Because of the suspended material, the water gets undesirable appearance. Next one is a foam. Foam or float indicates suspension of gas in water. Foam may develop in water either by fall from height or by the presence of some chemical matter. Usually foam is present in the water because if water is fall from certain height, then foam will get create or due to the presence of chemical material. If the foam is due to the fall of water from the height, it will not create any problem. It will last for some seconds. But if it is from the some chemical material, then it will last for a long period. The important agencies responsible for the foam formation in water are certain natural compounds, soap, detergents, and certain trade waste. Certain industrial waste, soap, detergents will create a foam in the water. The pollution of water by foam may prove to be serious, as such water is likely to carry suspended matter including pathogenic bacteria. The whatever the foam form in the water will carry suspended matter and pathogenic bacteria along with it. Because of this reason, the foam formation is also objectionable in the water. Next one is a chemical pollution. The chemical pollution of water occurs due to the presence of inorganic chemicals or organic chemicals. The pollution due to inorganic chemicals, the inorganic chemicals are acids, alkalis, toxic inorganic compounds, dissolved inorganic substances, suspended inorganic substances. These are the inorganic chemicals which will create chemical pollution. First one is acids. Acids are contained in industrial waste of certain industries, such as factories producing DDT, high explosive factories, battery factories. These will dispose of acids in the natural water body. The water containing acid is harmful to the aquatic life, and it leads to corrosion of metal or concrete structure. The water which contains acids is harmful to the aquatic life. Along with that, it also leads to corrosion of metals and or concrete structures. The presence of acids destroys bacteria and other microorganisms. It seriously affects the process of self purification of rivers or streams. Along with that, the presence of acids also dangerous to the or also avoid the self-purification of rivers or streams, because the self-purification of rivers or streams are due to the presence of microorganisms or bacteria. The acids will kill these bacteria and microorganism, and self-purification of water rivers or streams is not possible. Next one is alkalis. Alkalis are contained in industrial waste of certain chemical manufacturing industries or chemical consuming industries. The presence of alkalis in water has the same effect that the acid has. Next one is the toxic inorganic compounds. Certain inorganic compounds are toxic to fish and other aquatic life. These compounds are derived from the industrial waste of certain industries such as fertilizers, coke ovens, gas leakers, alkali producing factories, etc. These are the industries. Because of this, from this industries, toxic inorganic compounds will be produced. The important inorganic compounds include pre-chlorine, chloramines, hydrogen sulfide, soluble sulfides, ammonia, salts of many metals such as chromium, zinc, lead, nickel, copper, mercury, silver, etc. These are the important inorganic compounds which will create the chemical pollution. Next one is the dissolved inorganic substances. The dissolved inorganic chemical substances include minerals and gases derived either naturally or from certain industrial waste. And when they are present in small concentration, they are harmless to fish and other aquatic life. If these dissolved inorganic substances are present in a small quantity, they will not create any problem. The other effects of such a substance will depend on the nature of dissolved mineral or gas. Most of them cause hardness, some impart color and other odor in the water. This dissolved inorganic substance usually cause a hardness in water, or they may impart color and odor to the water. Next one is the suspended inorganic substances. Clay, sand, silt, etc. are the suspended inorganic substances. The effect of these substances is to turbidity to water. The suspended inorganic substances will impart turbidity to the water. Next one is the pollution due to organic chemicals. The fats, proteins, carbohydrates and other organic substances present in water, either in suspended form or dissolved form, cause its pollution. The organic chemicals get entrance to water body either through the sewage or industrial waste. The organic chemicals easily come to the water or natural source of water body either through the sewage or industrial waste. Algae, fungi, decayed leaves, etc. impart acidity, color and taste to water. The presence of dead animals, insects, etc. cause growth of harmful bacteria in water and too dangerous to the public health. If dead animals or insects are present in the water, they will cause growth of harmful bacteria that may be dangerous to the public health. Next one is a bacteriological pollution. The bacteriological pollution of water occurs due to the presence of pathogenic bacteria, certain fungi, pathogenic protozoa, viruses, parasitic worms. These are the pathogenic organisms which will cause the bacteriological pollution of the water. These organisms multiply excessively in water bodies, and from the viewpoint of public health, they are injurious and harmful, and hence they are not desirable in water. The growth of these pathogenic bacteria is very fast, and they will create a public health problems and injurious and harmful, hence they are undesirable in the water. The important sources of bacteriological pollution are domestic sewage and industrial waste of certain trades. These are the sources of bacteriological pollution. Solid excreta from human bodies and decomposable organic matter of sewage provide an excellent medium for the development of bacteria in water. These are the mediums which will helpful to the growth of bacteria in the water. If sewage treatment plants and water treatment plants are not properly operated, there are chances of bacteriological pollution of water. Now, if the sewage which is produced is not treated properly in the treatment plants, or if the water is not treated properly in the treatment plant, then there is a chances of bacteriological pollution of water, and it may leads to the outbreak of waterborne diseases. Fourth one is a radioactive pollution. The radioactive pollution is defined as the physical pollution of living organisms and their environment as a result of release of radioactive substances into the environment. In the environment, if the radioactive material is released, or radioactive substance is released in the environment or the atmosphere, which will create a radioactive pollution. Usually, the radioactive material will come from nuclear explosion and testing of nuclear weapons, nuclear weapons producing and decommissioning, mining of radioactive ores, handling and disposal of radioactive waste, accidents at nuclear power plants. Because of these factors, the radioactive material will enter into the environment, and they will create a radioactive pollution. Nuclear tests are carried out to determine the effectiveness, yield and explosive capacity of the nuclear weapons. Usually nuclear tests are carried for the purpose of to check the effectiveness and yield and explosive capacity of the nuclear weapons. The proportion of radioactive pollution is 15% of the total energy of the explosion. The radioactive pollution of water sources and air space is the result of radioactive fallout from the cloud of a nuclear explosion. The radionuclides are the main source of pollution. They emit beta particles and gamma rays and radioactive substances. Next, we will come to some multiple choice questions. First one is some of the important chemicals producing taste and odor in water are the question. The given options are iron, manganese, phenols, and all of these. The correct answer for this is answer D. That is all of these. These all material will produce taste and odor in the water. Some of the inorganic chemicals causing chemical pollution of water are acids, toxic inorganic compounds, alkalis, and all of these. This is also option D, which means acids, alkalis, toxic inorganic compounds will create inorganic, these are the inorganic chemicals cause the chemical pollution of the water. Next, third one question, self purification of river is seriously affected by the presence of dash in the water. The options are oxygen, acids, organic material, none of these. The right answer for this is B, acids. Acids will stop self purification of rivers or streams. Next, fourth one question, bacteriological pollution of water occurs due to the presence of certain fungi. Options are certain fungi, B, parasitic worms, C, pathogenic protozoa. Fourth one is D, is all of these. The right answer for this is D, which means fungi, parasitic worms, pathogenic protozoa, these all cause the bacteriological pollution of water. Next one is the fifth one question, bacteriological pollution of water may result in outbreak of dash diseases. This is the question. The right answer for this is waterborne, which means the bacteriological pollution of water will result in the outbreak of the waterborne diseases. Next one is the main reason for increase in the temperature of natural source of water is, The main reason for increase in the temperature of natural source of water is, the right answer for this is, cooling of water from thermal and nuclear power station. Next, seventh one question. The biological activity in water at high temperature will be more or less. The right answer for this is more. The biological activity in the water is high at the higher temperature. Next, eighth one question. At higher temperature, amount of oxygen soluble in the water is more or less. The right answer for this is the less. At the higher temperature, amount of oxygen soluble in the water will be less. Ninth one question. Is the turbidity of water due to bacteriological contamination is dangerous to the public health? The right answer for this is yes, which means the turbidity due to the bacteriological contamination is dangerous to the public health. Next one is 10th question. Normally, foam in natural source of water is developed due to the right answer for this, is fall of water from the height or due to the some chemicals. This is the reason for which due to the foam is formed in the water. That's it. Thank you.